happening in Gaza. He could stop it, but it goes against all his interests. And so we are here to say that we are the red line. We are the red line against genocide. But beyond that, we are the red line against the U.S. imperialist project. We are the red line against colonialism. And we are the red line against the capitalist state that birthed terror. We are here to affirm that our struggle is for the total liberation of Palestine. From the river to the sea, Palestine will be free. And it will be free because the Palestinian people have the courage, have the resilience, and have all the political agency to birth revolution. We have the responsibility to break imperialism from within. To allow the Palestinian people to breathe. That is our task. It is our task to break U.S. imperialism from within so that the people of Puerto Rico can be free. We make the connections that those police officers causing havoc in our communities have been trained by the same terrorist forces that are in the occupied territory of Palestine. We understand that the reason we are suffering a housing crisis, that we cannot access healthcare, that we cannot access education, that our migrants are being attacked, is for the same reasons the United States imperialists launch war against poor people every day. And it is those connections, it is that deep understanding of what our task is that will free us as the people in the United States and will help the rest of the world breathe without the shackles and the terror of U.S. imperialism. We are here because we are committed to fight genocide.
Yeah!
Regardless of who the tenant of the White House is. Woo! And I will leave us with this. From the people of the Global South, from those who are Spanish speakers, for those who have suffered the terrorism of U.S. empire, we say, ni olvido, ni perdón. We are